Hello, fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the Syracuse Orange and the St. John's Red Storm. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
I'm really excited about the matchup in the power forward position. When they play well, their respective teams usually play well. Let's see what happens tonight.
Tonight we've got an interesting matchup at the power forward spot. Number 21 might be one of the best floor leaders in the country right now.
The player we'll be matching up with tonight is also a great leader. It'll be interesting to see which one can compel his team to victory.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Guys are in position, and we're ready for the tip.
And the first half is underway, baby.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Mary receives the ball. I think he was there, Dick.
Yeah, but that could have gone either way.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Douglas may have escaped one there. He shoots the jumper. Nope. Number 20 takes the pass. Gave it up.
He may be in trouble here, Brad.
10 seconds on the shot clock. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He grabs the rebound. A little two-man action. Cross court. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Rowe receives the pass. Pushes it up. Now looking to create with a ball screen.
And a pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great way to buy a step for the dribbler.
10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. He passes it out of the trap. Gave it up. There's a bad pass right to the defender. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
The tempo is definitely on the slower side. Something that works well for some teams and not so well for others.
On the dribble, gives it up for two. The Red Storms have got to continue to get him the ball.
Braddy's on fire.
Tries for two, and off the mark. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Douglas handles the feed, pushes it up. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Strips the ball. Barry's mediocre play has really gotten to him.
I hate to see a young man struggle like this.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Barry receives the ball. Cross court. Goes and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Perfectly executed. The shooting guard gets the pass. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. And one too many dribbles and a steal.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
For two. Doesn't go. The lay-in. Long down court pass. Buries it home. Eludes the trap there. Trying to pack it inside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Pushes it up. Tries for two. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds. Great finish off the transition, Brad.
Number 20 takes the feed. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Here a five-second call forced by that determined defense. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Brad, before the game, both coaches and players said they were looking forward to tonight's matchup. Whose weaknesses will be exposed and who will really step up, guys?
Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. Cross court. With a good look. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Passes it out of the trap.
Up and inside.
Goes up for two. 10 on the shot clock. He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
Full court pass. Cross court. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. but if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
Number 23 receives the pass. They work it back to the outside. Tries a three. Goes in. Rowe receives the ball. As the crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Looking for a good shot. For two. Up and in.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The lay-in. Number 20 takes the pass. Passes it out of the trap. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Pushes it up. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
Tickles the twine. Check out the replay, Dick. Definitely worth being part of our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Talk about highlight material, Mr. Nessler. That's a strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
The power forward with the ball. On the outside.
The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible.
He takes a three. It won't fall. The shooting guard handles the feed. Well, here's a look at the tempo for both teams tonight, Dick.
You know, it's crucial, Brad, that both teams stick to their style of play. If not, the chances of them winning definitely decreases. That spacing.
For the bucket. Up and in. Teams will play all sorts of tempos and styles these days, Dick. What are some of the characteristics of up-tempo teams?
One thing which stands out in my mind is the type of defense they play. Often up-tempo teams will press, trap, and disrupt the offense at every chance they get.
Goes up for two. Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
Hey, they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
Both teams looking to get things going here. The lay-in.
Let's slow it down on the replay.
The chance persists.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
And the ball goes out of play. Manning checks in for the first time.
I tell you, this is what they need coming off the bench, Brad.
Puts up the J. Sticks the deuce. They work it around the perimeter. The skip pass is picked off. Number 23 takes the feed. Defense made him keep it too long. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court.
Jackson receives the pass. They work the perimeter. turnaround jumper. He cleans the glass. Cross court. For two. The Orange have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Looking for a good shot. There's the rejection. His shot's blocked.
Hey, he thought he spotted space in that zone, but not today, baby. That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Number 12 gets the pass. They'll work it around the arc. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass up. Down inside for the bucket. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
On the outside. Execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Gave it up. Eludes the trap there. Now they work it around the perimeter. Pull up jumper, left side, off the mark. He goes right past the trap.
Right around the trap. I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
The shooting guard handles the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass. They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over. They come away with a basket off the break.
He unloads a three. He shows the sweet touch. Time, the Red Storm are up by 7. Dick, what would you say is the play of the half in this tightly knit affair?
I love this dunk right here, Brad. Highlight of the half for me. I'd love to see more of this in the second half.
Second half about to get underway. Let's go down to the action. Richard, there's a look at the points of emphasis. What are you seeing?
I'll tell you one thing. Their performance so far has got the coaching staff pretty upset. The lack of check marks says it all, Mr. Nestler. If they're not playing their style, it will hurt them.
Thanks, Mr. Vitale. We'll see how they adjust their style of play for the second half. Thompson finds himself back out on the court.
This team plays a lot differently when he's in the game, Brad.
Is that good or bad, Dick?
I think they play a lot more under control.
Dick, two great players now heading into the second half. We watched them through the first half, and they played it pretty dead even. We'll see what happens here in the second half.
I tell you, there's no doubt they're PTPers. They're primetime performers. They like the big moment, and they make big plays.
St. John's gave a great rebounding performance in the first half of this one, partner.
I'll tell you, great effort and great poise. That's a sign of a championship team, if you ask me.
Moving it around the perimeter. The ball goes out of play. Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Working it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. Moses receives the ball. Now trying to feed the low block. And the ball goes out of bounds. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
They go into the low block. Owen fakes the shot. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. For two. Perfectly executed.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
He looks for three. Gets it to fall. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. Nope. Gave it up. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
The shooting guard takes the pass. The Red Storms have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
Cross court. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Way to cover the ball on defense. It causes a 5-second infraction.
Dump it inside.
For two, up and in.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
Looking to move it around the perimeter.
The lane.
He strips him clean. Rowe handles the feed. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up with it. Nope. He gets the board. Length of the floor for the bucket. Thompson is feeling it right now.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Gave it up.
Escaped the trap.
The ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
Douglas may have escaped one there. He attempts the jump shot.
Excellent jump shot right there.
The center receives the pass. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? There was no doubt about that one.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
He shoots from the top of the key and come up short. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Up and inside.
And the ball goes out of play. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad, the player matchup has been our focus tonight, and he's been effective because his teammates are finding him in the right spots, and he's knocking down all his shots, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. Holman receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. The turnaround jumper. Strong rebound.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The ball goes out of play.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
The Red Storm seemingly have a solid number of seniors in their lineup, Dick.
Hey, Brad, you know I love seniors. By the time they're in their fourth year of eligibility, they're a solid and reliable basketball players.
Up and in. Inside. He shoots from the top of the circle. Coleman is getting it done for his team right now.
At some point, his team is going to have to step up and play at his level. He's carrying them right now.
On the outside. For two. The layup. Pushes it up. For two, up and in. Cross court.
Had a little trap really well there, Brad.
Jumped in front to take it away. Here they go in transition. Bucket, the layup.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. The Red Storm should consider switching their current tempo and mindset to more of a half-court game. With the time and score on their side, that seems to make sense to me, Dick.
At this point, getting defensive stops and having the time come off the clock is most important. If this means playing in the half-court, even though you prefer to play an up-tempo style, so be it.
The Orange are in a bit of a hole, and they're going to have to really crank up the tempo in order to erase this deficit.
Well, they like to play an up-tempo style, so they could have a chance. Quick scores and pressure defense may just help their case.
On the dribble, gives it up. And the ball goes out of bounds. They'll throw this one in from the side.
The frustration right there.
They have to start making some crisper passes, Dick.
Yeah, these guys are going after everything, Brad.
And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Hey, currently the tempo is definitely on the high side, Brad.
They're working around the perimeter.
With anticipation defensively.
Now looking to attack. Coleman handles the feed. Tries for two. They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
This one might go down to the final buzzer.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
Goes up for two. Up and in. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Coach has been pretty active over here on the sideline, providing some quality feedback to his players. I overheard him saying that he really likes the manner in which they've been playing. The up-tempo style is what they're known for and what they've been demonstrating so far. Don't look for that to change.
Thanks, EA. Aaron Andrews providing that extra bit of insight for us. Dumps it in. For two. Can't get it to go. Pushes it. For the bucket. In and out. Pushes it up. For the deuce. The layup is good. Gave it up. He strokes it. The missed shot. Pushes it up. Tries for two. The lay-in. Rowe receives the ball. They work the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. The Orange have got to continue to get him the ball.
Braddy's on fire.
That bucket cuts the lead to one.
I told you there was a lot of time, Brad.
Goes up for two. Goes in. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the York.
Cross court. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Number 20 gets the ball. Picked off. Cross court. He fires away. He misses the jumper.
Hey, dodge one there, Brian.
He takes the open jumper. Dick, what they need now is a quick score, right?
And use as little time as possible.
Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Well, nobody said it was going to be easy, did they, Dick? Coaching, that is.
I sure hope not. A lot of sleepless nights coaching a basketball team. The expectation to win consistently, not win occasionally, but to win consistently. Winning consistently is one that stresses out a lot of coaches.
It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
Looking for a good shot. Intercepted. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick?
Now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
And yet another foul. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
Turnovers, Dick. They just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts.
Ball coming in from the sideline. Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Nobody likes this point in the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Douglas has fouled out. And the clock stopped with a foul. They're set to throw it in from the side. And yet another foul. This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Makes his second shot. The Red Storms are all over the inbound. And timeout. The player's got a much-needed breather with that timeout. For two, up and in. Well, during pregame, we emphasize some points, and likewise at the half. Dick, now your final thoughts.
If I look at these points of emphasis, and actually grade a team based on whether they accomplished any of them or not. Based on my experience, teams who can't achieve most of these keys will have a good performance, simply because they're playing their style and within themselves.
Folks, it's all about controlling the tempo. If your team is playing their style of play, usually good things are going to happen. Dick, we can talk about matchups all we want, but really it's not just always a one-on-one matchup. There's a lot of guys out there contributing.
Well, that's how you win. You got to execute as a team. You got to make sure the right people shoot the shot. And I'll tell you, the PTPers are responding, but they're responding within a team concept.
St. John's saw their lives flash before them as they finally pull this one out.
With two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have